God's afternoon, everybody. Ooh, let me lower this one. All right, I'm back again with another coffee with Eyce. This one's gonna be a little bit different. I'm gonna share, I went through something about a year ago, and it was one of my most powerful testimonies, and I'm gonna share the link in the comments so you can go back and read it and get the detailed version of it. But what I wanted to share with you today was that experience that I had as I was reading through the Bible. My experience is in the Bible. It blew my mind. So I want to share that with you. First, I'm going to give you a brief description of what happened to me last July 2019, or was it June? Went to Solely Business, and before I went to Solely Business, I was feeling like God had withdrew himself from me. You know, I felt like maybe I did some things that, you know, pushed him away forever. So I went there with the understanding, because he gave it to me, that there's going to be something up there for me. And it's a miracle that I even got there. A brother, you know, asked me if I wanted to go, and I said, yeah, but, you know, I couldn't afford it at the time. And he said, I'm not asking you to pay. I'm asking you if you want to go. And I was like, I'd love to. So I get there. It's about 3 days of, getting ministered to and sharing experiences, testimonies and stuff, and just getting built up by men. So I walked through, they gave us an opportunity to go be alone and see if we can seek God. So I went out there, and I couldn't feel anything the first time. I was like, man, that's like my confirmation that God pulled away. Second time we went out there, I'm walking through these woods, and I see this cross out there just all by itself with the bench in front of it. And I felt God say, this is where I want you to talk to me. So I go out there, and as soon as I sit down, this warm breeze starts blowing, and I feel this embrace, like a warm embrace. And it was a beautiful experience. And I seen this bird fly right in front of me and land on a stump and just stare at me. And, you know, I'm like, oh man, this would be an amazing time to just, to praise God and worship God. But I didn't have no bars because I was in the woods. So I looked down at my phone and I had full bars. So I put on a worship song, and I'm like, you know, this is the perfect time. You've given me this opportunity and this moment here. So I put on a song called Nothing Else by Cody Carnes. And I look up, the bird's gone, and I'm all crying. And I'm like, God, where did you go? Where did you go? And I look over my head, and this bird is flying over me in circles. And I hear the words of the song. It says, take me back to where we started. And so as I was reading through the Bible, that experience, my experience is in here. So I'm going to read it to you. My solely experience is Psalm 77, 1 through 9. I'm just going to read it to you. And everything that it's saying is what I was going through before I got there. Let me lower this. I'm not sure if it's too loud. All right. Hold on, what's it? Okay, sorry about that. Psalm 77, 1 through 9. I cried out to God for help. I cried out to God to hear me. When I was in distress, I sought the Lord at night. I stretched out untiring hands, and I would not be comforted. I remembered you, God, and I groaned. I meditated, and my spirit grew faint. You kept my eyes from closing. I was too troubled to speak. I thought about the former days, the years of long ago. I remembered my songs in the night. My heart meditated, and my spirit asked, will the Lord reject me forever? Remember, these are the same exact thoughts that I was feeling before I got there. Will the Lord reject me forever? Will he never show his favor again? Has his unfailing love vanished forever? Has his promise failed for all time? Has God forgotten to be merciful? Has he in anger withheld his compassion? That is exactly how I felt before I went there. Everything that I just said, it's Psalms 77, 1 through 9. That was what I was feeling before I got there. And then this part when I got there, Psalms 77:10 through 14 is what I experienced. When the worship song said, "Take me back to where we started," he was reminding me, I'm still here, you know, reminding me of the things that I've done in the past, reminding me of every time that he's came through for me and showed me his presence. So this is Psalm 77:10 through 14. This is what I experienced when I was there. At that moment, I felt the Holy Spirit. And then I thought, "To this I will appeal, the years when the Most High stretched out his right hand. I will remember the deeds of the Lord. Yes, I will remember your miracles of long ago. I will consider all your works and meditate on all your mighty deeds. Your ways, God, are holy. What God is as great as our God? You are the God who performs miracles. You display your power among the people." That is what I experienced there. The reminding, the miracles, the everything that I've had as far as experiencing with God and the Holy Spirit, and just knowing Jesus is there. Everything that I felt at that moment was a reminder. God showed up and he showed me who he was, who he is, and who he will be tomorrow. Never changes, never fails us, never goes back on his word, never leaves us nor forsakes us. God is always, always, always right there with you. No matter where you are in life, no matter what you're going through, no matter the doubts, no matter the struggles, no matter the falling back, no matter the holes that we put ourselves in where we think we can't climb back out, we think we're stuck, we think we went so far back that there's no coming back. We feel like we've done so many mistakes and made so many mistakes that people are gonna look at us different, but none of that matters. All that matters is God is with you. He isn't going anywhere. All he is doing is waiting for you to turn back around, because he is right there waiting for you. All right, guys, I wanted to share that with you. I thought it was an amazing thing. I'll be back next week with another word. Love you guys. God loves you. That's the most important thing. God bless.